When making a case statement, sometimes you need to categorize parts of your data before having it apply to your main case statement. This is called a nested case statement. Let's take a look. In this example, we have a when statement to show the wages for managers and an else statement for all other employee types. We also need to know if they are a full-time or part-time employee and not just a manager. With a nested case statement, we can add criteria to give part-time employees a different salary amount. Here we show a case statement where if the hours worked column is less than 40, then they are considered a part-time employee. If that evaluates to true, then we give them a salary of $40,000. If that does not evaluate to true, then it will move to the next when statement. It is important to note that the order in which you write when statements matters, as it will stop evaluating a single row of data based on the first statement that proves true. This case statement ends. However, it is not given a name because the name is only given to the outermost case statement, which belongs here, minimum salary. Let's preview the data, and we should see the same results as before, just this time using the nested case statement. Case statements can nest as deeply as you like, but remember to be careful because this type of code can get complicated quickly. And that's how you create nested case statements in Domo.